With October being Breast Cancer Awareness Month, we're giving you a look at how mammograms are done and what signs to look for.
And that's why we sent Dallis Ontiveros to Adventist Health Castle in Kailua with all the details. Morning, Dallis.
Good morning, Christine and Kelly. That's right. With October being Breast Cancer Awareness Month, we are here continuing the conversation about mammograms and what signs to detect early on. Now, here joining us on Take 2, we got Jonathan Cho, who is an oncologist here at Adventist Health Castle. Good morning. Aloha.
Good morning. Thank you for having me this
morning. Thank you for having us today. I mean, there's so much valuable information that we want to squeeze in, but, you know, continuing where we left off in the first half of Take 2, when it comes to the average of women being diagnosed with breast cancer here in the state of Hawaii, what is that number that we could share to the public?
Well, in year 2019, there'll be about 1,200 cases of new cases of breast cancer in Hawaii for 2019.
And that's, I heard a little bit earlier, that's 1 in 8 women who are diagnosed with breast cancer
here.
Yeah,
that's, you know, one's risk of developing breast cancer, lifetime risk from birth to death is about 12%, so 1 in 8. Yes.
And I know it's really rare to hear men getting breast cancer, but I know if we look at the bigger picture of things, I know Matthew Knowles, who is Beyonce's father, just revealed recently that he was diagnosed with breast cancer. How often does it happen in men?
Yeah, there's about 1 case of male breast cancer for every 100 cases of female breast cancer. It does occur. They tend to be older than the peak incidence in female breast cancer, but yes, it does occur. Yeah.
Now, are there any preventative ways that people can do to prevent getting breast cancer in the future?
Well, I think number one, I think we have exercise has some impact on lowering one's risk of breast cancer. Diet, in terms of body fat, and certainly in postmenopausal women. Mm-hmm. And now we have abilities to look at high-risk patients or high-risk women who we can now use chemo-preventive or using drugs to lower their risk of breast cancer.
And you know, you named those different ways of preventing breast cancer, but what about your family history? Say if you have a long line of, you know, people in your family getting diagnosed with breast cancer, does that, you know, kind of beat the odds of getting breast cancer?
Yes, I think for an average breast cancer individual, there's about 7% of all women with breast cancer have a family history. Mm-hmm. Now, there's going to be patients who have a much stronger family history or certain types of breast cancer, a personal history, that will warrant a higher risk of having some genetic predisposition to getting that breast cancer. So genetic testing is a very widely used process now.
And you know, we're having this great conversation about mammograms and, you know, early signs to check for, but the reality is that there's probably someone at home who is dealing with breast cancer, living with breast cancer, or someone who knows someone who lost their battle to breast cancer. How do you break that news to them, and what do you let your patients know about the treatment process and the journey?
Well, I think it's important that information is broken on a personal level, usually in the clinic. I rarely do it over the telephone. Then we have to talk about, you know, what can be done for a breast cancer and the process to reassure the patients that, number one, they have a very curable disease and that we have very good therapy for them. So I think that's a lot of it is reassurance at the start of this whole process.
And really quickly, based on your personal experience, what do you think is the best treatment for people who are diagnosed with breast cancer and surviving it and beating it?
Well, it varies. It varies on the type of breast cancer. It depends on the extent of the breast cancer or stage of the breast cancer. And then it depends on the certain characteristics of the breast cancer. But most patients with breast cancer probably see 3 people. They see a surgeon, they see a radiation oncologist who does radiotherapy, and they see someone like myself who is a medical oncologist. And then we devise a treatment plan for each patient. But it does vary based on individual characteristics of their tumor, yes.
And it also goes back to the beginning of just getting mammograms done, looking for signs, checking your body. Don't be afraid to touch the areas that you think are a little bit suspicious or you feel a little bit odd. But I want to thank you so much, Dr. Jonathan Cho, for just sharing this valuable information with us this morning.
My pleasure. Thank you very much.
And of course, if you have any more questions or if you want to see these segments again, we'll have all this information later today on our website at khon2.com. Reporting from the scene, Dallis Ontiveros, sending it back to you ladies in the studio.
All righty. Thank you so much, Dallis. Well, still to come, Halloween Town isn't just a classic Disney movie.
That's right. It's a real place that you can visit.